All right, we've been through all of the tabs. Good job. I want to show you now a few items that may be useful to you before we say goodbye. Let's go back to the cover sheet. Sometimes you'll find that the windows here are too small or too big. You can resize all fields in CPRS by hovering your mouse over the border between two boxes until it looks like a line with two arrows. Then click and drag to change the box to the size that you'd like. You can do this in pretty much any tab in CPRS. Similarly, if we go to the Orders tab, and somehow your orders have shrunk, or the columns have become too hard to read, and we need to resize everything, like this, for example, over here. I have no idea what this is saying. We can hover our mouse over the line between the right orders box and the orders screen and click once, and the computer will automatically resize your orders to fit your screen. The next thing we'll want to do is create a signature code to sign the notes that you write on your patient. We'll go back to the cover sheet, go to Tools, and hover over Administrative Tools. Select eSig Sig Block. And then a new box will pop up where we can create our 6-digit signature code. This code can be made up of letters, numbers, or a combination of the two. Just make sure it's a combination that you'll remember. You can also change the tagline of your signature in the title block. The title block will appear at the end of all your notes as your name, position, and current service. I suggest using the title Nursing Student. Now we'll end with the VA intranet. To access intranet, click on the Internet Explorer image, which will automatically open to the VA intranet homepage. From this page, you can find information about the Portland VA and surrounding facilities. I like to use the Nursing Portal and Nursing Policies and Procedures. Both items are listed on the right side of the homepage. Click on Nursing to open the Nursing homepage, which provides several helpful resources, such as this Clinical Resources section, where you can find tools that can help you look up skills, videos, evidence-based information, patient education resources, and technological manuals. Now if we go back to the homepage, we can find Nursing Policies and Procedures on the right side. Before you perform any skill or administer a unique medication or drip, it's good practice to review the policy and procedure first. So this is where we can find all the policies and procedures for the Portland VA. And again, these policies are all related to nursing. And go back to the homepage. Another helpful link is the printers link on the bottom right of the screen under information technology. We can select this box and click to add a printer. And usually it's going to be in the Vapor App 15. And we'll have to do this every time you go onto a new computer. You'll have to set your default printer. You'll also need to know your unit's printer number to know the printer that you're looking for. Now you have a basic knowledge of CPRS from this video. However, if you have any questions or need reference material, go back to the intranet homepage. We can go down and find the CPRS instructions link. This link will send you to a written tool of CPRS instructions, and you can search for information about specific topics or questions. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you're able to use some of these concepts to ease the burden of navigating CPRS here at the Portland VA. If you have any more questions or desire more information, please utilize the CPRS instructions link. Your preceptor, clinical instructor, or leadership staff will also help you in your journey. Don't hesitate to ask.